Hey there everyone, it's AJ Van Rijkstel and I am back with another video. In today's video I am doing the digital part of my Tridigital piece for the competition that is on Newgrounds. You saw the video the other day where I did the drawing of these two characters and this was the final outcome there. For that I've now scanned that in onto the computer and I have already done the digital aspect of the traditional style character. So if I delete that now, there you go. I'm still getting used to drawing on computers. I did try to do a recording of me doing this drawing, but unfortunately due to some technical issues the recordings didn't go as well as I had planned. But as you can see here, I've got that done. I'm quite happy with it. It does seem quite a simple style of thing. I've got the two samurai swords there and things, but hopefully eventually I will get better at doing that. I was just adding the little bits here for that. So if I just selection deselect, and as you can see there, I've got the two images and I just want to get rid of these two. Oh dear. Oh, digital, there we go. And then I've got that there. As you can see, I've got the two sort of like there. Now, in today's video, what I have planned on doing is the background digitalized. So I have just finished doing that on paper, doing the drawing of the background on paper. So what I want to do first is I want to export this image as a PNG. So this is the image and as you can see here I've got the way I've done this is sort of, I thought I'd do a nice like sort of battle sort of scene with different images going there, and then I have done it in such a way that I'll be able to actually separate these images a bit and move them about, so I'll be able to like move this and have this as like more of a background like further in the distance and things like that. So that's what I'm just going to do now. As you can see, I have now got it so that these become separate images and I can manipulate them where I want them to go. So if I add this one back here, the foreground one, take that off, I've got this here. So if I selection deselect, I can then move this wherever I want in theory. There we go. Move that wherever I want, and it means then that I can even enlarge it if I feel that I need to enlarge it, and I can position these around in different places. So I've got this here, I can put that up there, I can make that a bit bigger. It just gives me a bit more play around with the different images that I've created for that. So yes. So that's that done. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to add to the various different images. I'm going to make it a bit simpler so that I can see what I'm doing. Going to add, no, not all that, but I no longer need that one yet. So if I go back onto the foreground, which is this one here, and move that there like that, I'll now be able to just add a few little tones to it just to bring it a bit more to life. I want to have the background sort of with this sort of manga style grey tone. So what I'll do is I will do, as you can see, I've been a little bit busy and I have done quite a lot on this. All that's really left now is to add the extra bits to it. I want to get that a bit more there like that. just add the extra bits to it really, which are the two characters. I'm going to try and put them in the centre here, but because I've done this now the way I've done this, I should be able to, let's just make that a bit darker, I should be able to now move these a bit more if I need to move them, and then have them more here. So they're going to be aiming to be around here, and obviously I want to still be able to see this behind, so I might have to move this a little bit to that side and things like that, but that should give me enough playround time now for that. So I'll just quickly import those. So I'm back, and as you can see, I have now done this, and I was just having a quick glance over it. So what I've done just to finish it off is, because it's this cross between traditional and digital, I thought I would do a sort of half and half. So I've used a tablet thing here, just as a, I'll just move that accidentally, just as a bit of a border, so it can see that it's on the tablet there. And if you look closely here, there is just a bit of texture, just to show like a sort of canvassy type thing. So I just thought that would be a nice little touch to add on that there, so that you can like see the cross between digital and traditional art there. So that's pretty much me done for this. I'm actually quite happy with the way this turned out. I did find it quite fun to do, and I really like this sort of illustration style that I did on for the actual drawing of the background. It's kind of the first time I've really done such an in detail background. I've done it, as I say, a bit sort of rough around the edges, just because it's kind of like I sort of wanted that sort of like fighty sort of style there. So that's why I've used some of the greens and greys in there, and I did decide to limit the sort of colors that I was using for the background, so just to tie in with the colors that I've used on the characters, I figured I would just add like the red touches there and things. And I just thought I'd add something in the background there with the girl flying over the Wacom with the Wacom pen there. So that's and frame. So that's me done on this video really, just for that. I just wanted to show you. So I will show you the image at the end of that all. So until next time, ta-ra!